Welcome. My name is Wei Qingjiang with Department of Lifecycle API. Here on behalf of the Office of New Drug Products and the Office of Pharmaceutical Quality, OPQ. I'm joined today by Niru Takiya and Captain David Skanky, also with Lifecycle API. In this webinar, we will be discussing and demonstrating the documentation required for filing ANDA with Cocrystal drug substance when submitting drug master file. The mission of Department of Lifecycle API is to review generic drug substance master file. Generic drug is pharmaceutically equivalent and therapeutically equivalent to brand name drug. A generic drug works the same way and provides the same clinical benefit, including efficacy and safety, as its brand name product. This slide shows Orange Book's definition. Pharmaceutical equivalents are drug products in identical dosage forms and route of administration that contain identical amount of the identical active pharmaceutical ingredient, API. That is the same salt or ester of the same therapeutic moiety. Pharmaceutical alternatives are drug products that contain the identical therapeutic moiety or its precursor, but not necessarily in the same amount or dosage form, or the same salt or ester. For example, tetracycline hydrochloride versus tetracycline phosphate. Pharmaceutical equivalence of drug substance was further addressed by FDA guidance on solid polymorphism. In this guidance, polymorphic forms refer to crystalline and amorphous forms as well as solvate and hydrate forms. In the same guidance, the following are defined. Crystalline forms have ordered or defined arrangements and conformations of the molecules in the crystal lattice. Amorphous or non-crystalline forms consist of disordered arrangements of molecules that do not possess a distinguishable crystal lattice. Solvates are crystal forms containing either stoichiometric or non-stoichiometric amounts of a solvent. If the incorporated solvent is water, the solvate is commonly known as a hydrate. This slide compares salt, polymorph, and co-crystal. Salt is formed by proton transfer from an acid to a base. Polymorph is two or more crystalline forms of the same active pharmaceutical ingredient, API, with different arrangements of conformations of the constituents in the X-ray crystal lattice. In co-crystal, both neutral substances, API and co-former, are present in the crystal lattice without proton transfer. The third column noted that salt is different from freebase API, so a new drug application, NDA, should be filed. On the other hand, polymorph and co-crystal are considered as the same API, so abbreviated new drug application, ANDA, should be filed. To address the co-crystal as same API, FDA published a draft guidance in 2016 where FDA suggests treating co-crystal as polymorphs as long as proof is presented to rule out the existence of ionic bonds. 2 years later, in February 2018, this guidance has been updated to include a specific criteria to distinguish between co-crystal and salt. The following slides will discuss this criteria in detail. From this slide on, we will walk you through an example using publicly available data to explain principles laid out in the Cocrystal guidance. Anti-leukemia drug Ibrutinib was approved in 2013. It is first-line treatment for chronic lymphocytic leukemia (CLL), small lymphocytic lymphoma (SLL), and first treatment for marginal zone lymphoma. It marked the number 5 annual sale in 2019 with more than $8 billion sales in USA alone. Drug substance Ibrutinib is class 2 under BCS biopharmaceutical classification system with low solubility and high permeability. Ibrutinib polymorph solvates and their stabilities are reported in a 2016 patent. Polymorph form A, B, C are anhydrous non-solvated, while form D, E, F are solvated polymorph with different solvents, such as methyl isobutyl ketone, toluene, or methanol. Among all these polymorphs, form A is more stable than other polymorphs. In the same patent, preparation of ibrutinib cocrystal with weak acid, such as benzoic acid, fumaric acid, and succinic acid are reported. The pKa range of these three weak acids is between 3 to 5. Note the pKa of conjugate acid of ibrutinib base is 3.74. Also notice the aromatic hydrogen on the pyrimidine ring, also known as hydrogen 3. Its chemical shift delta is characteristic of cocrystal versus salt. This will be used as additional evidence to meet FDA criteria. Single crystal X-ray diffraction showed that each crystal lattice contains a homodimer of ibrutinib connecting via hydrogen bonding between amino group on each molecule. This ibrutinib homodimer forms another hydrogen bonding with fumaric acid. There is no proton transfer from fumaric acid to ibrutinib base, which is supported by the significant difference in bond length of carbon-oxygen single bond and carbon-oxygen double bond in fumaric acid, which is 1.32 angstrom and 1.20 angstrom respectively. This slide line by line summarizes the CDER cocrystal criteria and how the reported data meet this criteria. FDA criteria for cocrystal has three parts. Number one, both API and coformer are present in the unit cell. The reported data showed ibrutinib homodimer with one fumaric acid are observed in single crystal X-ray diffraction. Number two, if API and its coformer meet the criteria delta pKa equal to pKa of conjugate acid of base minus pKa of acid smaller than 1, then no substantial proton is transferred, so cocrystal is formed. In ibrutinib fumaric acid case, delta pKa equal to pKa of conjugate acid of ibrutinib base 3.74 minus pKa of fumaric acid, which is 3.03 equal to 0.71, which is smaller than 1, indicate no hydrogen transfer and it is not a salt but a cocrystal. Criteria number three, if pKa criterion does not apply, orthogonal approaches such as spectroscopy can supply evidence. For ibrutinib fumaric acid case, there are two additional evidences. Evidence one, proton NMR showed 0.3 ppm difference in chemical shift for hydrogen 3 in pyrimidine ring in salt versus ibrutinib free base. No difference in chemical shift observed for ibrutinib free base and fumaric acid co-crystal. Evidence 2, difference in bond length, which is carbon-oxygen single bond and carbon-oxygen double bond, in fumaric acid support no proton transfer. Conclusion. The compliance of ibrutinib fumaric acid co-crystal with criteria listed in FDA guidance has been demonstrated. Ibrutinib fumaric acid co-crystal is the same API as ibrutinib free base. This slide listed some helpful resources that you can use when preparing your DMF submission. Link to FDA guidance for pharmaceutical solid polymorphism. The link to updated co-crystal guidance. The website for FDA generally recognized as safe GRAS list for co-former selection. And the DMF question email inbox, where you can submit questions regarding DMF submission policies and procedures. This concludes our presentation. Thank you for your time and attention. Thank you for taking a look at this poster. After viewing this webinar, please remember to submit your questions regarding this poster to the link provided on the poster page. Questions received by February 15th will be included in the March 3rd poster question and answer session. Questions received by March 19th will be included on a follow-on webinar on April 9th, 2021. Please refer to the poster by Babu Gadam for synthetic therapeutic polymorphs recommended documentation for API sameness. Please refer to the following presentations on March the 4th for additional information by Babu Gadam, considerations for complex APIs.